Today's news show is brought to you by The District on Kernan, where life happens.
Good evening, Ospreys, and welcome to your Osprey TV news. UNF's police department recently received a substantial amount of money to upgrade their equipment to further protect students. Ospreys TV, Andy Levert reports.
UNF's University Police Department has recently received $120,000 from the United States Department of Homeland Security. The money will go to the Mobile Command Unit with a plug-and-play mobile communication system that will allow the university police to be in constant contact with one another and other law enforcement agencies in the area. I was curious to see what students thought were other good ways for the UPD to spend money on campus. Opinions on the matter varied. Here's what some students had to say.
I mean, we can probably just have more security, like surveillance cameras.
I mean, like hearing about how someone got the master key or whatever, like that could have been easily solved if we had cameras.
A canine drug force, maybe two or three trained drug dogs. And then all of a sudden, you know, you have like a DEA task force on campus.
Probably more security during the night.
Yeah.
I think there should be a lot more cameras. There should be hidden cameras around the parking lot, especially around the library since it's open until
2 a.m.
Yeah.
We will report back with more information from the University Police. This is Andy Leverett reporting for Osprey TV.
The UPD expects additional grants in the coming semesters for upgrades such as these to provide further protective services. Award-winning journalist Juan Wallace will be on campus later this month for the 30th annual Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Scholarship Luncheon. He writes for newspapers including the Washington Post, the New York Times, and the Wall Street Journal. He is an Emmy winner for the television documentary writing. He has won a political commentary award by the American Association of University Women and has achieved many other accomplishments. He will discuss Eyes on the Prize, America, and the Dream at the event. The luncheon is being hosted by the UNF's Intercultural Center for Peace. It will be held Thursday, February 24th, from noon to 1:30 p.m. in the University Center Banquet Hall. Doors will open at 11:30 a.m. You must bring your UNF ID to attend the luncheon. The tickets are $30 each, $500 for a table of eight and table signage, and $1,000 for a table of eight, a table signage, preferred signing, recognition in the program, and a thank you from the podium during the luncheon. The first 150 students who arrive get a free ticket. To buy a ticket, call the number on your screen. Ever heard of Donna Deegan's National Marathon to Finish Breast Cancer? UNF's housing mechanic Dennis Holler has spoke on camera about it for Osprey TV.
The ultimate goal of the foundation is to finish breast cancer. The marathon started 4 years ago, and that year my wife was a volunteer at one of the water stations, and the following years we became more involved with the foundation, not only with volunteering, but also with running. We joined the Galloway group and started running and raising money, and it gave my wife and I something to do together, not only to be healthy, but also help with a great cause in Jacksonville. Well, UNF students can get involved with the foundation by going to www.breastcancermarathon.com. We're always looking for volunteers, and if anybody wants to sign up and run for the marathon, the half marathon, or the relay, you can still register online or come down to the expo on the 11th and 12th down at the Prime Osborne Convention Center downtown.
If anyone is interested in getting involved with this worthwhile cause, just visit the website on your screen and make a difference. Have you ever thought about being a certified lifeguard? UNF is providing students with this opportunity. The instruction course will begin at 2 p.m. Saturday, February 12th in the Aquatic Center, Building 26. You have to complete the pre-course session first. The pre-course session will take place Wednesday, February 9th and Friday, February 11th, from 6:30 to 9:30 p.m. For more information, visit the student update page under My Wings. And now for your YouTube viral video of the week. Be careful with this one.
Take it slowly. This book is dangerous.
Well, that's all for today. Make sure you check out this Ospreys TV Movie of the Week, The Social Network, presented by the District on Kernan. Have a great night, everyone.